again, if this is your first time, welcome to the Culture Movement. We're just getting started. We got some music for you. We got some video content for you. And today we got Summer Jam tickets for you.
Summer Jam.
We got Summer Jam tickets for you. So going down August 22nd, you know the biggest concert in the world is the hip hop, is Hot 97's Summer Jam, right? So we usually do it in June, but because of 2020 and certain things got pushed back, we're doing it August 22nd. That's in like 2 weeks. No, that's not 2 weeks. It's like three, four weeks. But we're giving away tickets tonight. We're giving away two pairs. So you'll have two chances to win. And I'm going to let you know how to do that in a little while. But for now, we're going to bring in my brethren.
Ready?
We good? Let's bring in the brethren, yeah.
He's in there. We in there. Rosenberg, what's good? Rosenberg, what's good?
We good?
Nothing.
Yo, Rosenberg, what's good, brother?
Chilling, man. What's good? How are you guys?
Welcome to Culture Movement Monday.
Listen, I've been a longtime fan of Culture Movement Monday. Shawnee Culture, Robert Merrill. I'm here.
There we go.
Thank you, brother. Thank you. Thank you. The horn was a little loud. Just, you know what I'm saying? Just. Nah, I appreciate you, and I've seen you support us for a long time. I've seen you reposting your IG stories whenever we're going live, jumping on the comments, and you show love regularly. So, you know, in exchange of love, because that's how the universe works, and you know I'm all about the universe, you know what I'm saying? So the reciprocation of karma, you know, and energy. Say something again. I saw you say something, but I didn't hear you. I want to make sure your levels is right. Nah, I can't hear you. How come I can't hear him?
1 2 1 2
Yeah, there you go. There you go.
That was too low now. How's that?
Let me hear you again.
1 2 1 2
Perfect.
There we go. Yeah. All right. No, I know you are a man who loves the universe. Your whole everything about Shawnee Culture is universe. Your brand is universe.
That is a fact. Remember, I had the t-shirts. Do not disrespect the universe. Early. So just in keeping the reciprocation, you can turn the music down just a little bit, and the reciprocation of energy and the fact that you dropped your album, you know what I mean? I want to push that. You know, I want to talk about what got you to actually want to create this album, come up with some of the content for the artists that are on the album. I know for people, I saw you just looked up. You have a camera that's facing you, but you're also looking down at your camera and the phone. So if y'all see him not looking down, it's not like he's not interested. It's that he's engrossed in the show. You know what I'm saying?
That's when I look down, I'm looking at Shawnee, and then I look up at the camera, correct?
Right. Looking up at, and I do the same thing because I'm over here reading comments, but the camera's over here. So, you know, it's how we do it. But yeah, so I want to get into what made you come up with the album, what made you feel like you wanted to come up with an album, the people on the album, the type of content, and we're going to go into some videos, and then you also will be appearing on Summer Jam. So we're going to talk a little bit about that too.
Correct. There's a lot to do, man. I mean, it's a good time, man. I'm on the most sort of invigorated about music that I've been in a long time. So I'm excited to share about that process, man. And I sent the link to a bunch of the artists from the album. I DM'd it to them, some of the producers. Gray Matter, who was in the room a minute ago.
Nice.
I sent it to a lot of people. Oh, my girl who designed the cover art, Miss Hatton, she's in the room.
Big up Miss Hatton. Yo, I love that name, though. I'm going to keep it a buck. You know what I'm saying? Like Manhattan, but Miss Hatton. I like the wordplay. She's hip-hop. Where's she from?
Of appreciation.
Where's she from? I just want to know. You know what I'm saying? What borough, what city, what state? Yeah.
Oh, she's from Queens.
Oh, Queens. Oh, I feel like I might have known that. Big up everybody from Queens. You see, I got my shirt on. I don't know if y'all can see representing. You know what I'm saying? The special borough of Queens. You dig? A lot of good artists. So anyway, let's get into the movement. So, bro. So you have an album, it's called Late, Real Late. What was the first idea of coming up with an album in general? Why did you feel like you needed to make an album?
I guess it was like a mix of things. It had been something, you know, I made a few mixtapes over the years. I made three different mixtapes. I made one Cypress Hill mixtape back in the day that they had sort of enlisted me to do, where I got artists to like cover Cypress Hill records. Mm-hmm. That was several years ago. And then I also did a branded mixtape a few years later called What's Poppin', where I got like original music from Kendrick, Action Bronson, Danny Brown. I had all kinds of big name artists on this project. And then I did another tape, New York Renaissance, which was like that, but it was all artists from New York. And then I would say sometime after New York Renaissance, you know, over the last 10 years, life started getting in the way, having all the jobs and things going on in my life. I found myself sort of a little disconnected from the music. Okay. You know?
As you was like, just kind of like working your career out and going, pursuing your dreams in other ways. Because you also do, if y'all not familiar, you know, you've been a sports enthusiast, you know, your whole life. You know, I know this because we do a morning show together for people who are not familiar. So I know you've been a sports enthusiast and you've been a wrestling enthusiast as well. And you've pursued careers in each of these genres specifically, right? So now you got hip hop, you got wrestling, and you have ESPN Sports. So you felt like you needed to come back to the source?
Yeah. So it was like, even though it was such a blessing to have all those jobs, I found myself a little disconnected. You're getting older. I mean, listen, we all hang out and everyone on our morning show is, I mean, full disclosure, we're all just above 40, everybody. So like, we're sitting there like, you know, you're trying to listen to the music and some of it we feel and some of it we don't. We just play it because it's what it's the music that's programmed at that time. And if you don't work really hard to stay connected and you have other things going on, it's easy to find yourself disconnected. And so at a certain point, I was like, I realized after going through like some hard times in life that I was like, man, you know, coming back to the music makes me feel good. It makes me feel alive. It makes me feel like the person I've always been, like before any of this, like the 15-year-old who wanted to do this was always about music. So coming back towards the music just brought me a lot of personal joy. And then, the pandemic happened. Mm-hmm. And when the pandemic happened, you know, we're all at home now, you know, and then I met Miss Hatton. So new love in life and feeling inspiration and good things and better vibes than I'd felt in a long time. Yeah. It felt just like a good time. And I started reaching out to see what I could get done. And I started putting together these songs. And before I knew it, I was like, yo, I got a handful of joints here. Like this could really be something. And yeah, it just became a real beautiful process that I loved doing. And now I'm sitting on this 13 song album that, you know, I really consider to be one of the best albums that came out this year.
And you surprised a lot of people with the product, with the outcome. I remember at the time that you went in.
I'm glad you said it. I think I surprised some people as well.
Yeah, I mean, I remember when you dropped it, you said that you had nothing but positive tweets. You know what I'm saying? And you expected some pushback and things of that nature, but you kept it authentic. But before you get into that, I want to ask you real quick, in terms of like, what was your first love? Was it hip hop? Was it wrestling? Was it sports? Just a quick question. Do you remember?
It was a first, I guess sports just ahead of hip hop in terms of order. Yeah. Very similar timeline, but maybe sports just ahead of hip hop.
Yeah. So you said, and I remember you saying that one time that you really connected with Fife Dawg from Tribe Called Quest, Queens, because he was a rapper and always wore basketball jerseys.
Yeah. I loved Fife. Tribe was my favorite group. And B, yeah, the sports part of it, you know, made me really connect. Didn't realize till all these years later, getting to know them and be blessed to have relationships with them over the years, that Q-Tip loved sports almost damn near as much as Fife did.
Really?
But Fife repped it. And so, I always felt a kinship to Fife because of that.
So now when you were growing up, because, you know, there's been controversy, or I don't even know if we want to call it controversy, but you said, like, you know, some people will say you adopted into the hip hop culture or whatever because you're not black or whatever, right? But having a true passion for hip hop, coming out with a hip hop album at this point, what was some of the struggles, or did you stand out, or were you like a rebel, or like just kind of the concept of loving hip hop, being so engrossed? Who were the first inspirations? And what were some of the maybe obstacles of being somebody that supposedly is on the outside of the culture trying to get into the culture?
That's a super dope question that actually I haven't been asked during this whole time. And big ups to people in the room, my people, Hip Hop Mike's in the room.
Yeah.
Disco Vietnam, who did three joints on the album, he's in the room.
Yeah.
One of his big joints up in a minute.
Willie Colon, too. Willie Colon commented happy birthday to you. You know what I'm saying?
What up, Willie? My man Willie Colon in the building.
Willie, what up?
Starker, the artist, is in the building, man. A lot of people in here. So I would say that coming up, you know, it was an interesting time to be growing up a white kid from the suburbs into hip hop, because it was actually unique back then. And now these days, I still meet parents, like a lot of like white parents who I meet out like at an event, like a, you know, maybe it's an event for the ESPN show, for the Michael K show. It'll be like a 55-year-old dad, 60-year-old dad. And they'll be like, oh, you know, my son actually really likes hip hop. They still think it's novel because they're out of touch. But I'm like, every white kid likes hip hop. That's not even interesting anymore. Right. It's not even a point worth mentioning, honestly. But at that time, in the late 80s, early 90s, it was actually interesting because, you know, we were the sort of early ones to jump on and really be interested. And my brother, you know, was, he was the main reason I got into it, which is because he was so into it. And
so wait,
it
was
fun.
What was the first song?
Kind of a niche thing then.
What was the first song that penetrated your soul that you was like, yo, if you can remember that? It might be, you know, sometimes you're 2 years old and you're already in the hip hop, so you don't know the first song.
So yeah, no, it wasn't that, because I'm the same age as hip hop, yo. I'm July 1979, and you know, in terms of commercial releases,
yeah,
I'm the same age as hip hop. Rapper's Delight dropped July 1979.
Got you.
Obviously the culture we know started, you know, 6-7 years before that, but in terms of the music being out there, so I aged exactly with hip hop, and I would say the music that first really got to me that I loved, Kane, you know, Ain't No Half Stepping. Like I knew, like knowing the words to Ain't No Half Stepping.
You think we'd be able to play that? I don't know. I don't want to get cut off the live. Yo, kick me a bar, son. You know I'm gonna put you to the test. What is a bar from Ain't No Half Stepping? I'm trying to remember myself.
Rap a step and show me. They won't get some, but I'm the Kane. So yo,
you know the outcome.
Another victory. They can't get with me. So what did you say? BC, so take your PC.
BC before Christ. So pick your BC date because you're history.
BC date because you're history.
All right, that's good enough.
I always thought he said kick Capri C Dave because you're history.
Capri C Dave?
I thought he said something about kick Capri there all the time. I don't know why. Maybe just because I'm a DJ. I have no idea.
I also never knew. I knew Shawnee would know, but I was like, what did he say there?
Yeah, so pick your BC date because you're history.
Half stepping, hitting hard. But I also want to mention, because people forget it too often, in terms of a lot of white kids from the suburbs really discovering hip-hop,
even though
the song is kind of hokey or corny or whatever, parents just don't understand by Jazzy Jeff and the Fresh Prince had a really big global impact too.
Around that time too, you know, it was okay in R.I.P. Biz Markie, who also was a character with his music, it was okay to be kooky in hip-hop, you know, everything, it was cool to be kooky, you know what I'm saying, and to make fun of yourself and to be like, I got played and she says she's just a friend, or parents just don't understand. And that was a part of the creative love of hip hop, that it was from the street, but you could still show vulnerability in that way. How many love songs in hip hop was like the dude got played? You know what I'm saying?
Exactly. What about LL Cool J, I Need Love? Even that, you know, he's kind of playing a simp.
When I'm alone in my room.
Sometimes I stare at the wall. I mean, come on, it's a little sad.
Right.
By the way, shout out my man Wrestling for Sale in the building too. Ted, what up, LA?
Yeah. Now that's dope. So yo, we're gonna talk some more. I wanna get into one of the songs. The first beat that we were playing was Real Late. Who's on that song?
Speaking of LA, that's Vel the Wonder. She's from LA. It was produced by DJ Skiz, who's right here in Brooklyn. I got put on to her by my man Mark, Top Shelf Premium, and I was like, yo, this Vel the Wonder is amazing. I was talking to DJ Skiz about some other stuff, and he was like, yo, I actually have a joint with Vel the Wonder. And he played me that song, and I played it in the car, and I was with Miss Hatton. We were in the car, and she was like, yo, this sounds like an intro right here. I was like, you know what? This does sound like an intro. So we changed it. We took out the drums at the beginning, made some little changes to it, and it ended up being the intro to the album.
Nice. I love it. So we're going to play that joint right now real quick. Let the people get familiar. Remember, get your headphones so you can hear this properly. This is the intro to the album Real Late. The album came out where? When?
June 4th. Streaming everywhere right now.
That's right. All right. So this is the intro to the album Real Late. Put on your headphones. When we come out of this song, or when we finish playing this song, we're going to go into some actual video footage. You know what I'm saying? So y'all just vibe out for a little while. Let's listen to the tune. Welcome to Culture Movement Monday. Get your headphones, you know what I'm saying? Hot 97 IG Live, DJ Rob De Niro. My name's Shawnee Culture. We here with Peter Rosenberg. Rosenberg, baby, at late night. Rosenberg, baby, at late night.
Rosenberg, period, late night. La 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 with the good time flow. Think about my bitches in the good time hoes. Time will tell where the good time goes. Real rowdy at, we gon' let the good times roll. I'm mistaken, my baby, she acting real crazy. Bombing on a Sunday, Monday, she acting real lazy. Come back with no shoelaces, more blue faces, more cool cases. Hey, she smacking real ladies. Real in the greenest block, welcome to the chronic. Sword skill, samurai, pull katana out the comic, yeah. I'll make them sick, marijuana out the vomit. Invigorating my skin, terracotta, cop the tonic. 2001, still Dre, bumping the miles of sun. Explosive, now most of them got the gun. The next episode is where the ride will be gone. Now to be one, you need to survive and kind of be fun.
One, two. Yeah, we live real late. It's real late. We featuring the album Real Late. This is Culture Movement Monday. If you're just tuning in, you know what I'm saying? Shawnee Culture here, DJ Rob De Niro, Peter Rosenberg. You know what I'm saying?
Peter Rosenberg is a super fucking dude right now, man. I guess y'all got an issue with that, you know what I mean? I'm gonna just reiterate it. Peter Rosenberg is a super fucking dude right now, man. He's the only motherfucker on the motherfucking megahertz frequency that's still trying to, you know, implement that filthy under the nail, holy sacred and pure.
Yeah, yeah, that's fire. That's fire. Really, that's fire. Yeah. That's fire.
I'm not gonna lie.
You're not gonna lie. You know what I'm saying? You're not gonna lie. That's fire. Tell us her name again.
Her name's Vel the Wonder Man. She's so talented and she's so unique. Like, her style as a person and as a rapper. Like, I really don't think that exactly what she's been doing has been done before. Like, if you go look at what she does on Instagram and, like, then listen to the kind of records she's making, like, yeah. I don't know. She's this sort of hybrid of very much being a woman and looking the part and having style and all that. While I'm talking about being a backpack underground rapper. You know what I'm saying? Like, she really blends a lot of different things that we haven't seen done. I just think her voice quality is amazing.
It is.
Her control is fire. Like, she's just a really, really talented artist. Shouts to Vel the Wonder. And Skiz body that beat. And I was so happy when he made it the intro. He went and found that Sean Price sample. Like, I never thought about using that the late, great Sean Price had referenced my show on a record. I forgot. Like, he just found that. And I was like, oh, shit. That's so fire for the intro to have Sean Price of all people.
Come on, Sean P, Brooklyn Zone, RIP, man.
The funny thing is, that bar is kind of, he kind of makes fun of me on that bar, too. He really, the full bar is, he goes, Rosenberg, play me at late night. I'm too old to blah, blah, blah to listen to late night. Like, he says he doesn't listen.
He tired, he going to sleep. You're too old for that.
So big ups DJ Skiz for finding that. Rest in peace, Sean Price.
Word, word. So who's some of the other people that you have on the album and what went into the selection of these artists?
Let's see. There was, you know, every track's different. You know, I wanted to get a variety of people who sort of represented what was going on in the underground today and the artists that I play on my show Real Late, which I do right here on Hot 97 every Sunday night at midnight. So I wanted to get the artists that I've been supporting and enjoying on the show. So, you know, there's Flea Lord is an artist who I've been playing a bunch on Real Late, who puts out a ton of dope music. He's from Far Rock. You know, and I put him on a record with Stove God Cooks, who's been one of the most bubbling underground rappers the last few years since he was originally signed by Conglomerate, Busta Rhymes.
Queen Elizabeth said the whole album is fire. You know what I'm saying? Miss Hatton said, Lord, Lord.
Yeah, Queen Elizabeth said that?
Queen Elizabeth. the real Queen Elizabeth. Yeah, she said the whole album is fire.
And it really is. I mean, like, I got blessed, man. I got a record with Styles P. You know,
Styles Smoke
Pizza and Ransom.
Smoke Pizza. Ransom.
He has a new album out, and they bodied it. And then I was fortunate enough to get blessed by, you know, original Wu-Tang members. I got a record with Meth and Ray.
Nice. Come on now.
At the last minute, I ended up getting a Ghostface verse too. We got Ghostface, Jim Jones, and Crime Apple on a track. So it's a mix of artists who I admire, I've always loved, and I have relationships with. It's a mix of them and then the artists that I'm currently into today. But, like, to be honest, I'm not going to claim there's some incredible artistic thread beyond my ear. Like, this is all just shit I fuck with, which is ultimately why, you know, at the end, when the body of work feels so much, it's so me, is that it really is. Like, that's really the only common thread. Some people say it's a New York album, or it's an old school album, or it's, but it really is, the common thread is it's the kind of hip hop that I really enjoy. That's really what it is.
Yeah, yeah. Big up Absolute, the rapper, in the comments. So you didn't necessarily want to go like pop mainstream right now, current, you know, DaBaby or, you know, Lil Baby or Drake. You didn't want to go that route. You wanted to, like you said, this is the artist that you fuck with, that you grew up with, that you were inspired by and wanted to bring them forward.
Well, I mean, first of all, yes. Because that it's what makes sense for my brand. Like, I've said this to you, you know this, but like, I have a really dope commercial, one really dope commercial song that I'm sitting on in the stash.
Okay.
And I love that song, but if I had dropped that out of nowhere, it would have really made no sense. Right. Like, I just don't think people would have understood why I was putting that out. And I don't think it would have made me happy and feel fulfilled to try to be chasing down these rappers. The Baby and Lil Baby don't give a fuck about me. I mean, let's just be real.
Keep it a thou wow, my man.
I mean, I would say, I would be an asshole and say I don't give a fuck about them, hey. Except I love Lil Baby. I think he's dope.
Word.
But we don't have a relationship like that.
Right.
You know? So I don't have the same history with a lot of those cats. I'm not getting a Drake record. I can't even get a Drake interview.
So
I might as well go to the roots that are me and the artists that I have a legitimate, you know, positive relationship with, a relationship with mutual admiration, hopefully. And that's what I ended up being. And I was able to put some of these legendary artists on tracks with new producers who they would have never gotten to hear otherwise.
Dope.
You know, so I got to hear the Satisfaction, you know, when I talked to Grey Matter or Disco Vietnam, you know, or Buck Dudley or Zumo or any of these guys, to find out who they got on their records. It was like, oh shit, what? You know, or Benji Socrates, everyone. They were like so excited to find out who jumped on their record.
Right.
And it allowed me to really play a force, kind of a force of good in everybody's career, like putting young cats on to legends they admire and getting to put legends who I admire onto young cats who they wouldn't hear otherwise. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Now I know you got, you got some Wu-Tang members on there too that you mentioned. What was the first Wu-Tang song that was like, you know, I just gotta keep going back a little bit. And I know you've always been a big Wu-Tang fan. What was that first Wu-Tang song that you heard that your head said?
Oh, I mean, from the very beginning, man. I mean, it was probably Protecting Neck, really.
For real, right? For real.
Yeah, I had the vinyl single for Protect Your Neck before I even had turntables.
Really?
I didn't have my turntables yet, but I bought the 12-inch of that for some reason. I guess it looked cool.
Yeah.
I saw it at a record store, and I got the record of Protect. It wasn't the promo at the time. It was the Loud. It was the one on Loud with the jacket or whatever.
Yeah.
Right away. Protect Your Neck
and
Method Man. I mean, that single alone, that set it off. That was it.
So now we have some footage. What is this first footage that we're going into?
Perfect you say that, because this is second generation Wu.
Ah.
You know, this is children of Wu-Tang Clan.
The children of the Wu-Tang Clan, second generation Wu.
Exactly. And it's also dope because the shouts to Intel, who's U-God's son. Without Intel putting together this record with me, I don't know if the album would ever happen, because this was the first song I got done. Shouts to Disco Vietnam. I said, send me some beats that I could give to the children of Wu-Tang. He loves Wu-Tang. He sent me some beats. We ended up getting this song, which is called Wu Generation by Second Generation Wu, produced by Disco Vietnam, off that Real Late album.
So let's get into it. Let's play the video.
So we gotta, you know, intro that video.
That
was the intro for the song.
No, but you're right, Rob, because was live at Supply and Demand in Brooklyn in Bushwick a few weeks ago, and we set off the whole thing. One of the members of Second Generation Wu is Young Dirty.
Okay.
And he comes up to me. This is actually funny, Shawnee. He comes up to me beforehand. He's like, yo, can I do a couple joints on the set? Like, what joints can I do? And I was like, ah, oh, man, I don't have a lot of time. I'm thinking in my head. And I'm like, well, what songs do you want to do? He was like, I want to do Brooklyn Zoo and Shimmy Shimmy Ya.
Okay.
I was like,
come on now. Of course.
Like, And I forgot, because I'm used to Young Dirty. I've known him for many years now.
Yeah.
I forgot. Like, if you've never seen him before and you come out, you will think Old Dirty Bastard is on that stage.
Really? Yeah, I know. He has his energy every time I see him.
I'm like, what am I thinking? This is the hottest way to set the set off. What are we doing? Get out there. And you'll see the results. It turned out pretty awesome.
Dope. All right, so let's get into that. I want to see what that looks like. I didn't get a chance. So everybody, if y'all paying attention, or I know y'all paying attention, get your headphones. Let's check this out. This is Wu-Tang Second Generation, and this is some video footage. When we come out of this, we're going to give away some Summer Jam tickets. You know what I'm saying? Some Summer Jam tickets. So stay tuned. Keep it locked. We're going to watch this and come back out. All right? Get your headphones. Share to your friends. Shawnee Kota, DJ Rob De Niro, Kota Movement Mondays with Peter Rosenberg. Second Generation Wolf. I'm going to be in the comments.
Very desperate to try it.
That was a vibe, man. That was a fun time in there.
That's the energy. This the beat right here. Real late, Rosenberg. Y'all like what you're doing, man. I like what you're doing, bro. Real hip hop, true to form.
So
bro.
Who was it exactly on that record? Who's the second generations on there?
The actual second generations of Wu-Tang themselves are Young Dirty and You Godson. And the other cats on there are like affiliates, other different Staten Island. They're like connected familially,
yeah.
But not descendants of Wu.
Yeah, that's fine. All right, so look, right now we're going to give away these Summer Jam tickets because you're going to have an appearance on the Summer Jam stage. So who is going to be on the Summer Jam stage?
Let's see. It's going to be officially, we got Vel the Wonder, as the aforementioned Vel the Wonder on there. We got Stove God Cooks. We got Lee Lord. We got the legendary, iconic Rock Marcy. And then one cat who's not on the album, but is an artist I play a lot on my show real late. We got Conway the Machine from Griselda. He'll be in the building.
Dope. And this is your first Summer Jam appearance, like Rosenberg Presents, right?
Yes. I've never done it. I'm simultaneously very excited and terrified about it. It's going to be great.
Yo, it's going to be fire. It's going to be fire.
The performance I'm worried about, like, the performance is good. Like, once I'm there, I set up all the songs. You know, I know how to get on the turntables and introduce people. That's no problem. It's about the day of, like, trying to coordinate everyone that makes me concerned.
Right, right, right. So, yo, I want, like, we want to get some people in the building. Everyone, so. We want to get some people in the building, bro. So, Hot 97 has been... you know, gracious to bless Culture Movement Monday with some Summer Jam tickets. We have two pairs. We're going to give away one pair right now. All right. So they can be in the building to see Rosenberg real late on stage, as well as everyone else that's going to be performing at Summer Jam. But we focused on this right now, Rosenberg real late. So if y'all want to be in the building, August 22nd, MetLife Stadium, New Jersey, Summer Jam, biggest hip-hop concert in the world, as Hot 97 does each and every year. That's going down. And you want to win tickets. This is a very meticulous way to win tickets.
Okay,
all right?
How do you do it?
So now, if y'all mess it up, then you don't win. So this is for people who can understand and comprehend how this is going to go down. So what you're going to have to do, y'all paying attention, you take a screenshot on your phone of what you're seeing right now. You put it in your IG story. You tag Shawnee Culture, you tag Hot 97, and you hashtag Summer Jam ticket giveaway. Right.
Summer Jam ticket giveaway. So you at Shawnee Culture, at Hot 97, hashtag Summer Jam ticket giveaway.
I like that you've made it this hard. You really limit the amount of things you'll get here.
Exactly. And we're taking the ninth person.
They got to pay attention. Ninth person from right now. So
the ninth person. It's so out there. You're taking a screenshot. You're putting it in your IG story.
Screenshot.
You're tagging Shawnee Culture.
Not tagging. At.
It's just, at. You're adding yes, Shawnee sir. Culture. Hot 97.
At Hot 97.
Hashtag Summer Jam Ticket Giveaway. Make sure you spell it right. You know what I'm saying?
And you got to spell it right.
Giveaway.
With got the it. Hashtag.
Right. With the hashtag. So the ninth person.
Now I know why you and Rob De Niro are friends. He likes to explain things to dumb people.
Yo, you just, you know.
Yo, we got to over-explain sometimes. You know, some people going to get it wrong. Some people going to get it right. And we're going to shout out the winner. And we want to make sure. Now, we'll shout out the potential winner because we got to make sure you qualify and all that stuff. We know we got people from all over the world that's on this IG Live. So we want to make sure you qualify. But the ninth person, take a screenshot, tag Shawnee Culture, tag Hot 97, hashtag Summer Jam Ticket Giveaway. You know what I'm saying?
Get two.
Put that in your story. We'll see the mentions. We're going to count the mentions. The ninth person, you win. You going to Summer Jam.
Going to Summer Jam. That's what's up.
You know what I'm saying? So I want to get into some more footage. Let's get into some more footage. You know what I'm saying? So what is this next piece that we're going to watch, bro?
This is going to be another song from the album. This was Fly Anakin and Nicholas F, produced by Gray Matter. It's called I Want It All. They're both a couple of cats from Virginia. Actually, all three of them are from Virginia. So it's called I Want It All. It's fire. And yeah, this is from Supply and Demand a few weeks ago in Bushwick.
All right, let's get it. Supply and Demand. Culture Movement Monday. Y'all know what to do if y'all want to get these Summer Jam tickets. When we come out, we'll announce the winner. It's Culture Movement Monday. DJ Rob De Niro, Shawnee Culture. We are here with Peter Rosenberg, real late. Yo, so you got like this look like some real vintage footage.
I think that was a very long time ago, but it wasn't. It was 3 weeks ago. I do love doing shit though, like having and that was shout out my man Top Shelf Premium. It's his event, and he puts up a lot of freestyles on his Instagram, @TopShelfPremium, and he shoots everything with old school VHS handy cams to get that feel. It is a dope feel.
Dope. So do we got a winner yet?
How many we got? We got a few.
Some
down.
People are.
We're skimming through them.
Yeah, we're skimming through. So, all right, I know you said you were a little nervous about the Summer Jam appearance. Do you have any tricks up your sleeve?
Oh, I have tricks up my sleeve. Yeah, I got some tricks.
Okay.
You know, you can't tell Summer us, Jam's but... a day of madness. know, people always show up. There's always going to be some things. Frankly, I'm going to keep it very basic until I get there, because I know that weekend when the time comes, there are a few people who are going to be around that day. Who'll be like, yo, let me come out on that stage real quick. So you can guarantee it's going to be something. It's going to be a moment. I mean, you can look at the names who are on the stage, and if you're an underground head, you could probably figure out some people who might show up. I might call on some more cats from the album. We'll see. We'll see how many backstage passes I have, Shawnee. You know the game.
I know the game. Do you already have your outfit picked out? Because you know Summer Jam, you got to step out looking fresh, bro.
So funny, man. I used to like really. Yo, Shawnee, you remember back in the day, we used to put in real thought into our Summer Jam outfit.
You had to. This was the whole concept. What am I going to wear for Summer Jam on the big stage? 60,000 people.
Like, it is something that's changed probably between like when I was like 36 and being 41. Like, at this point, I'm like, you know, I'm not saying I want to wear something fresh. I'm not going to wear a stained shirt, you know, but I don't know if I'll put the same amount of thought that I used to. You know, I used to always come with a fresh jersey. I don't know why Summer Jam always made me wear a Mitchell and Ness throwback jersey.
Right, maybe.
I'll go back to that again. Who knows?
Yeah, hit a throwback. You know what
concert,
I'm saying?
Right? You don't need to OD. Like, it's an outdoor concert too, so you don't want to go like too over the top, like fancy with it, because it is. You're not going to a formal ball.
Right. Yeah, nah, you're not doing that. You want to come out casual. You want to let the people know, look, we here to party. You know what I'm saying?
Yo, listen, I'm just trying to survive that weekend. I got Friday. I have an event for ESPN in New Jersey. We have a beach bash every year. That's Friday on Jersey Shore. Saturday night, I'll be in Las Vegas for WWE SummerSlam. And Sunday, I have to be back for Summer Jam. So I'm just trying to survive the weekend.
Wow. That sounds
like jet lag.
Jet lag, right? For real, right?
My goal is just eat real healthy that weekend, drink lots of water, and stay on point, you know, so I can make it through.
Yeah, that's kind of dope, though, because a lot of times that means you don't have too much time to think about it. You know what I'm saying? You'll be kind of busy, and you can just come out straight with spirit. You know what I'm saying? Because you kind of like, you've been doing a lot of stuff. You're not at home filling your thumbs, wondering about every little thing. You're just active. And when you come out on stage, it's just all heart. You know what I mean?
Yeah, that's true. And big ups to my man, Hip Hop Mike. I've hired Hip Hop Mike to run things for me on Summer Jam Day, so he can deal with all the annoying messages.
So real quick, Shawnee.
Yo,
so
Droopy 7K said he's wearing a tuxedo.
So far, we had a bunch of requests for the Summer Jam tickets, but we only have four that qualify, that spelled everything right.
They misspelling so Summer Jam ticket giveaway?
They're not putting the proper things in there. So we're up to number four. We're being real, you know, official with this.
We're being real official. So keep it coming, man.
So what do they have to do again?
Keep it coming. We're gonna give away another pair of Summer Jam tickets.
So tell them one more time what they have to do.
Yeah, before we get out of here, because you know we got another pair. So it's take a screenshot, right? Put it in your IG story. Tag myself, Shawnee Culture, tag Hot 97. And just put the hashtag Summer Jam Ticket Giveaway.
Summer Jam, hashtag Summer Jam Ticket Giveaway at Hot 97. At Shawnee Culture. Yeah. That's easy enough.
Yeah, put it in your story so that I can see it, so that Hot 97 can see it, and so that the world can see that we're giving away Summer Jam tickets. You know what I'm saying?
There you go.
That's it.
It's going to be a fun day, man. It's going to be a fun day.
It's
going to
be a
fun
day. And we'll contact you in your DM, and we'll get the information from you so that you can claim the tickets, and you will be out there with us on August 22nd, representing with the people. What's another song that we could get into as we get up out of here?
Let's get a song, and then we'll have a winner by then, for sure.
Hey, you know what? Let's hit this one right here. Snake Eyes, man.
Snake Eyes.
Another disco Vietnam banger. It's Ghostface, who sounds, man, he's in his bag on this. It's Crime Apple, and it's Jim Jones. It's all off that Real Late. It's produced by my brother, Disco Vietnam.
Dope. Snake Eyes, let's get it. Culture Movement Mondays, Shawnee Culture, DJ Rob De Niro. We premiering, not premiering, but we're showcasing Rosenberg, Peter Rosenberg's album, Real Late.
Yo, bring this back, Rob De Niro. Do something crazy here, man.
Yeah, hit some cuts. Get busy with it, Rob. You know Rob is nice. DJ Rob De Niro.
Alright, there we go. There we go. Let's let it ride right now. Let's let it ride. It's the Peter Rosenberg, Ghostface, Crime Apple, Jim Jones, off that Real Light album, Snake Eyes. Let's go.
Make sure y'all get your headphones, man. Get your headphones.
And we'll have that winner right after this.
Yo, I used to tag dance all around a nigga jaw. DeWine's flair, put an iron sheik in the figure four. Two little niggas holding, going, sticking liquor stores. Eeny, meeny, miny, mo, motherfucker, pick a door. We coming gunning, don't grab it like Cheo's son. And we old, the cops pull us over, we laugh and rip the summons. Cruise on boats, stuff our hundreds in the gold vase. Found right beside Tut, in between both legs. Goka Royal cigars while I'm buzzing off a dope plate. Flying in a Swiss Alps, bulletproof North Face chefs that do jiu-jitsu, Wu-Tang ritual. Bricks being broken on a scale, being shipped to you. Hairy chest, BG music, you can sniff it too. Scatter and Fat Nose Larry, they can sniff Peru. Designer shit, only the official should listen to. My pockets on a chicken coop, got all my ops miserable. Popped up in the physical, 200 Hispanics. Now we wondering where his man went, start to stutter and panic. All this butter on my hands, I ought to cover the planet. Rich homies hitting my line like you should come to the Hamptons. I just be lamping in the Benz, counting president faces. But lately one I tend to see the most is Benjamin Franklin. It's no dancing, y'all retreating when we enter the function. A grown man become a fetus like Benjamin Button. Chickens love it, wanna rub my stomach, even suck soft dick. I only bust 3 times during sex if I'm exhausted. December, you might see me in Colombia eating swordfish. Summertime, I got a fever, risen teeth, frostbit. A mí ni me hablan de chavo, I'm getting paper cuts. Todo lo que yo tiro pesado, you gotta weigh it up. You turn up, stuffed in luggage in Lithuania. I pop up blunted with Rosenberg at WrestleMania.
Capo, Hex Rosenberg, about a very first encounter. He was talking slick shit, that could have been his worst encounter. I was fresh out the kitchen, I was still weighing working counters. Trip of the world for the work and I take it to the out of towners. When Ghost was up in Harlem, chewing ice cream for the butter pecans. I was up in Harlem, getting rid of them butter C-grams. That catch a body for 10, catch 2 for an extra 3 grand. By the power of Grayskull, the dust had him feeling like He-Man. When Barkley was at the line, shooting foul shots with a black eye. I was really up in housing, supplying the fiends with a crack high. There's 5,000 ways that you could break down a crack pot. Niggas either duck or get struck by these bullets when the mag fly. Yeah, we that fly. Diplomats, I'm back by my gang. You get attacked by boy when he out by the act.
All right, that's a vibe right there. Jim Jones, Ghostface on the same track. That's crazy. I don't think they ever did. Did Wu-Tang ever do something with like Dipset?
What was the collaborations that the groups were doing?
Wu-Block. Ghostface, remember they did Wu-Block.
Right.
Right.
Wu-Block. That was Wu-Tang and D-Block in
there. There's no Cameron. There's
like Cameron never. Cameron had
Dipset. I think someone told me there might be a K-Slay record that has Dipset and Wu on the same record.
There's also a K-Slay record with like 101 rappers. So
exactly. Everybody. So this was unique in that regard. I mean, as far as they knew, I think Ghostface and Jones thought it was their first time on the same record.
That's dope.
Shouts to my man Fatboy Sharif in the room too. Another dope artist from the area. Shouts to Sharif, man.
Yeah. Alright, so yo, we got a winner, man, and we gonna get up out of here, brother. You know what I'm saying? So the winner is big up Dark Skin So Wavy. Dark Skin So Wavy.
Dark Skin So Wavy.
Dark Skin. You know people's IG names, you know. We get creative out here. We get creative. But Dark Skin So Wavy, congratulations. Hit her with some horns. Hit the guy with some horns. You know what I'm saying? And we're going to contact you in your DM. We're going to get your name, your phone number, your email, and we'll make sure that you qualify. You will be, if you qualify and everything is correct, you'll be in the building with us. You know what I'm saying? You'll be able to see that Real Late with Rosenberg live and all the other artists that's going down. You know what I'm saying? Darskin, look, she in the comments. That's me.
Is she in the comments? She's in the comments. There she go. There you go.
Thank you. God bless y'all. Respect, respect. Dark skin so wavy.
Are you from New York? Where are you
beautiful
from?
Beautiful black queen. Yeah, put up where you from, you know what I'm saying? But we'll qualify you. So, yo, Rosenberg, Pete, man, you know it's infinite love, man.
Always, brother. I appreciate you. I love you. Thank you for having us on. I enjoyed it, man. I really enjoyed this conversation. So everyone who's listening, who's here, go check out the Real Late album. Come through that Summer Jam Festival stage. We're closing it out. You don't need to rush to get into the building. There's going to be a line anyway to get in the building. So stay through the whole set at that festival stage. And Rob De Niro, thank you, man, for playing the tunes, playing the videos. Big up Top Shelf Premium. Everyone who's involved in the album, Miss Hatton for the incredible artwork. Appreciate you guys.
Yeah. What's one song we could play on the last minute side? We'll take them out like that.
Let's go out with the joint I might make my next single. It's called SRD. Styles P, Ransom, DZA, produced by Buck Dudley.
Word.
I think that's one you and I both think we've always thought would sound kind of good on the radio. So yeah, let's give that joint a spin.
All right. Yo, Rosenberg, one love, brother. Appreciate you. I'll see you in the morning. One love, y'all. That's Real Late. That's Rosenberg. You know what I'm saying? Peter Rosenberg. Y'all done know already. ESPN Zone. You know, Wrestling Zone. I grew up on WWF. I think it's WWE now. It's the fire joint right here. Before we get out of here, it's Culture Movement Monday. You know what I'm saying? Big up to our guest, Peter Rosenberg, for stepping in with us in the building. And Dark Skin So Wavy, congratulations to you. You know what I'm saying? You will be in the building. We got another winner too, because we asked to do it twice. So, but we'll DM you and let you know exactly who it is. But as of right now, Dark Skin So Wavy, we will be contacting you and making sure that you're good and make sure you get your tickets. Once I contact you and get your information, then I-97 will contact you further to make sure you get your tickets. You know what I'm saying? Second generation Wu in the building. I see you. All right, Shawnee Culture, Hot 97, DJ Rob De Niro. Peter Rosenberg was with us, you know what I'm saying? If y'all just tuned in, amazing things, yeah, that's how we do. Let that rock.
Let's go.
Yeah, I'm cool, but I'm petty as fuck.
Headphones.
I'm gonna take the beat his ass when he said it's enough. Roller J, take a puff. Underground, but I'm over the top. Enough's enough now. Fuck the pigs, over the slop. I'm like Stallone with the hat back. Over the top, but I don't arm wrestle. I add a bomb wrestle. I'm a nuke when I'm in the booth. I'm a bronze vessel. Have you seen a brown mutant? I can look in the mirror in the pitch black dark, see it versus shine through it. I can kill an industry. I put my mind to it. I can look at the sun and say it rhyme to it and the moon too. Know why I'm aligned to it. Yeah, it's the ghost of Peter Rosenberg. You get your millimeter if you know the word. Better light is joined if you know the time. If you ever seen a Jedi, then you know the signs.
Yeah, but what happens when both our souls align? A soldier's prime is often wasted on war. Never forget it, there's no credit for older rappers whose flows decline. Niggas walk a tightrope but never can toe the line. I'm so refined that niggas who watch me could never know the time. So sublime, my vivid verses console the blind.
Yes.
Hot-headed niggas spitting the coldest rhymes. Drop dead and niggas figure they know the crime. Control your mind with torturous imagery. There's no synergy. I cynically destroy all lyrically without sympathy. This meant for me. I was placed here to be a messiah. Born in fire, raising hell like a note that's raised by Mariah. My vocals came with desire. I know you feel my energy. You think you lost a friend, but in fact you're gaining an enemy. Put my pain in this mentally. The only way I know to do it. You don't need to know me, my nigga, just know the music.
This one thing got me tripping, Anne-Marie. This high level's not eye level, you can't critique. Packs and pearls, lemon cherry from Canateek. Kicks from Joe Fresh Goods, I'm released. Let's make this quick, I had to go bust a sale. Watch gold mines crumble, niggas fumbled and fell. Check the weight on your own time, it's too much to scale. Appraisal for the piece worth 4 years in Yale. Kush God, all hail the rail. They talk tall tales, hope all is well, for real. The spot is hot, I had to keep off it. Switch the operation up, hit different resources. My people bagging up, doggy said he feel nauseous. Half-assed too, Fenty got a trippin' in the hazmat suit. Be careful with it, cause you really have to, or to be your last move.
Yeah, man. Peace, y'all. We do this each and every week to try to set off y'all week properly, you know what I mean? Culture Movement Monday, 8 p.m. New York City time. You know what I mean? So bless up to everybody. And we do have another winner that we're going to represent with. We'll DM you. We will DM you and get your information. But as of right now, we shouting out Dark Skin So Wavy. You know what I'm saying? Bless up yourself. Big up Brooklyn Unity Fest. And make sure y'all keep it locked. You know what I'm saying? Follow me, Shani Kosha. S-H-A-N-I, Kosha with a K. DJ Rob De Niro. You know what I'm saying? Follow him. Follow the Culture Movement. Follow Hot 97. Follow Peter Rosenberg. All right? We out of here. One love, y'all. Culture Movement teams. See you. Big up Adina. Big up Adina in the building. Adina in the building. Big up. Holding us down with them summer jam ticks.